Welcome back to Let's Play Amberstar Blind for the Amiga. I am Amethyst Lunatari. I actually just remembered, while I looked over my notes, and that helped me remember, there's a tree outside the Sylph cave. If I have this right, it should actually, well, there should be a tree with a key in it. So I'm gonna run over there. Let's see if we can get that. Now, there's also a healer in Burnville? And it's south across the water. I don't know how we would get over there. We need a healer. We need a healer, because we're out of potions. Potions are obviously finite, at least for the time being. So, no spoilers, guys, just sharing the current dilemma here. I don't think this is where I wanted to go. I mean, maybe if we go further down the coast, maybe we'll find a raft or something, but... yep, that's the Sylph cave. Okay, so then is this the tree? Maybe it's this tree. Is there another tree? It's starting to get dark now. We're in the water now. Yeah, it definitely hurts. Wait. In a hole in a tree, Citrine finds a strange little stone, which is astonishingly light. Weird stone. Good, because then we can actually carry it. I'm going to have to rest now. You have to click just the right spot on the tree. It is. It's 1 gram. Alright, so that goes in the... the indentation in that door inside. We need more rest. So now we have to rate to rest. Yeah, it would have effect. We'd get more more hit points. I think we're about 8 hours now. No effect. My arse. Alright, let's go. Now I'm hoping we don't have any huge battle through that door. Hoping we just find a treasure trove with presents. Not presents, potions. I bought some more torches off screen and sold our stuff down in the Rogues Guild. It's around this way. Trying to get the hang of this. Just checking to make sure I am where I think I am, and no, I was not where I think I am. I need to go around this way. That door is only on the other side. Moment of truth. Alright, I'm gonna save because I don't know what's gonna happen now. Do I use this here? Do I do a use thing? Can that be used? I think we have to look at the door. No, do this, okay. Citrina's unlocked the door. As you fit the strange stone into the recess, you hear a gentle humming, and the door opens as if by magic. Enemy? Or friend? Oh, they gotta be enemies. Ahead of you is a large cavern in which you see several young women. The strange thing is that they have blue or green skin and long, shimmering wings. Whoop, they're friends. When they notice you, they all flap their wings wildly, except for one of them. A reddish light spreads out around them. Then there is a sudden flash, and they are gone. Just the one remains standing in the cavern, looking at you with wide eyes full of fear. So they can disappear? So, no, I'm your friend. Before you stands a young woman with blue skin and long shimmering wings. She trembles in fear and stares at you with wide eyes. Sariel. Please do not hurt me. I am Sariel from the Sylph people. I stayed here because I need help for my sister. Hopefully that was not a mistake, but you do not look like devils. Well, thanks for that. Sister. My sister's name is Selena. The monsters that you call orcs surprised her and broke her wings. If I was stronger and could handle weapons, I would go immediately into the orc caves and free her. I hope just that she is still alive. But you are strong warriors. Could you not try to save her? I will also teach you our language because Selena understands almost nothing of your language. Come, it is very easy. She places her hands on your foreheads, one after the other, then closes her eyes and concentrates. Finally, she says to you in the Sylphian language, and to your surprise, you understand every word. Oh yes, before I forget, directly behind the entrance to their cave, the orcs have a stone head in the wall, which is apparently guarding the entrance. It seems to be able to speak, but I could not understand what it said or asked. So I keep clearing my throat here. Okay, they've got a puzzle mouth, or whatever they call it in this game. One of the orcs certainly said Ocknard before they all disappeared in the cave. Okay, that's the word for the magic mouth. Might be their deity. Alright, I'm gonna write somewhere around here. Ocknard. Puzzle mouth. Well, I want you to join our team. We need help. Maybe you can give us some potions. Sylph. To understand where we come from, you must know that at the same point where Lyramion exists, there are an infinite number of other worlds on other levels. They are only separated from each other by thin barriers. We discovered that we can overcome these barriers with the magic in our wings and can naturally visit the other worlds. Your world appeals to us because of the many shiny things there are here, for we love anything which shines and shimmers. But my sister was captured by these horrible monsters, and we are now very much afraid of your world. Yes, not all happiness and rainbows. Ocknard? Okay. You know, I wanna... What about these wine goblets? We found those already, right? Didn't they steal something else, like a badge of office or something? Let me see my notes. It might not be them, it might be somewhere. Okay, so as far as Burnville, though, I have a key. That's from Anthony, right? I think. Key opens a shortcut to Burnville. Go from Quay southwards to next island to get the tunnel. Alright, so maybe I do need to go along the south shore to the west to find that. Anything else? Burnville. I don't know anything special about hello. Orcs. Potions, we need potions. Damn you. Oh, and I could not find magical arrows. That's right, I wanted to see if I could buy regular arrows from the shop up in Spannenberg. I did not find any in the Rogues Guild, and then forgot to buy arrows at the shop. I think he has them. Join our party, damn you! Well, I don't know what it's supposed to do with her. I pray that you can save my sister. She flaps her wings rapidly, and a red shimmering light appears around her. Then the shimmering light flashes brightly for a moment, and just as it disappears, the sylph is gone. Okay, I guess... Oh, God. And now we don't survive, because I have no healing potions. I'm gonna try to focus on the same one. This isn't gonna... Sorry guys, they're just gonna wear us down. Oh, I forgot to even have him attack. Well, that's another good thing. It's probably better off for me to stay there. This is probably too late. It'll be a miracle if we survive this. So if we die here, I'm just gonna look... try to get to Burnville. We can find a healer there. Which is, Sabine, I believe? Then we'll have someone who can heal us. And we'll have another party member. Okay, Edgel's already... he's like half dead already. You're not doing well at all. We're attacking, doing no damage, failing with our attacks. I got rid of one. What if I have him defend? I'm not hitting the other one, so that's a problem. He's still doing damage anyway. I have no healing potions. Nothing at all. Nowhere to buy any. If we can get to Burnville, maybe we can buy some potions and get another party member. That might be the key to all of this. And I can't train up anymore. Well, that's Edgel. No, that's me. 70 out of 80? I guess I could have put more points into attack. I don't think it would make a huge amount of difference, though. And he could go higher, but he doesn't have any training points. One point at a time. He used the last of his ammo. And then he dropped the weapon, I guess on purpose, because... Who's the Orc Chief okay. Crazy. And he can't use a bow, this guy. He's got how many hit points? Six. Oh, he's not defending anymore. Just in case, have him defend. Yeah. I don't know, every once in a while I do one hit point to this guy. Who knows if I can even hit the Orc Chief at all? I haven't hit him for a while. 3 points, there you go. It heard me. Maybe we'll just try to run from the chief after we kill this guy. I'm assuming it would be easier to run from one enemy than two. Plus we'll get the experience from this one. I'm assuming. This is ridiculous. Hit him! I couldn't find any better weapons either. An axe does the same amount of damage as a sword. Three damage. Need some more of those. Nice. Hit him. Damn you. Sorry about this guy, he's always retreating. So I'll try to hit this guy while he retreats. He's moving back, alright. Come on, get him! Ugh. Guy's playing around. Alright, hit him before he backs up again. Give me 3 points. That's not 3 points. Damn you! Ugh. Just gonna wait, because he's gonna come back. I still have to redirect the attack. You can't hit me at all. But I can't hit him either. Damn. The wrong button. That's not what I was complaining about, though. He's coming back. Oh, I did 1 point of damage on him. If we can't get away, we could theoretically win this battle because he hasn't hurt me at all. It's just probably gonna take like an hour or something. I'm talking about against the chief specifically. Three damage. Three damage. I wonder if they regenerate at all, like slowly. Like every 4 rounds they get another hit point back. That means I'll never keep up. I did 1 damage there. Running away again. negative one damage on the Orc Chief, a total of two. Guys, moving back up. He's very indecisive. Oh, he's gone. Okay, so... can he flee? Agile flees. Well, I'm the leader. I don't think I can flee. I said no. You can't escape. Ugh. Can't even do anything yet. Agile with 3 hit points. So these guys came back. Yeah, we can't do this. There's no... I mean, if I wanted to sit here for hours, I could probably defeat them eventually. But who knows, I might break both my swords in the interim. Because it's a chance thing, so... if you're running for hours... that's gonna happen. Not moving. Okay. We're gonna leave and come back. Hopefully with a friend or two and some better resources, maybe a couple potions. That's weird though that we got to talk to that Sylph for such a long time and all of a sudden these orcs just show up. Like, you guys are just letting us have this whole conversation and then you're like, hi. Get away from the wall here. Is this... trying to find the way out. Let's go to the side. I guess we're not actually there. What we need to go... okay. I'm facing a wall, right? Sort of. Here it is. Just some time before a torch goes out. I can't rest. The only reason I'm trying to rest now, I know we don't need to, is because we're going to have fatigue. Alright, so now we have light and we won't have fatigue. So we have the key, we just have to figure out... You know what I've forgotten? At one point I used to know what this was. A quay. A concrete stone or metal platform lying alongside or projecting into water for loading and unloading ships. So, like, is that what we were near? That looked like a dock or something? Like a pier? Said it was a shortcut, but I don't have a raft. I don't have a boat. I would get one if I could afford it, if I knew where to get one. See, is that the quay? Leap of faith. Bloop, 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 bloop. So maybe that's not what she was talking about? Said it was a shortcut. Or maybe this. We already have a bridge that takes us there. I know it's this way because you can see it on the map. I wonder if that's water that doesn't damage you. It probably does, but... I'll save one more time. We can't even... Oh, that's like deep... Oh, it hurts us even if we don't move. That's like deep water, I guess? We can't even swim there at all. You said there was a tunnel or something. Sabine... Key open shortcut... to Burnville. Go from quay southwards to next island to get to tunnel. Island to the south in the middle of the desert. And then get word to Sandra. A key. Oh, my horse. Come on, horsey. I'm getting tired, that's nice. Anthony's key? I know this is stupid, but... Alright, I'm clueless at this point. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. We'll hopefully actually accomplish something. And always, seek adventure.